Welcome all to the European Spaceport for VA249 launch. As the InSpace Program Director for ETRSC, I am in charge of the Customer Interface and Launch Services Mission Preparation. And I have here the pleasure to present the satellite which will be launched in lower position of this flight. In July 2015, Airbus Defence and Space selected the European launcher for the launch of EDRS satellites. EDRS-C will be the second space segment of the European Data Relay System. It will enable ultra-fast transfer of data from low Earth orbit satellites down to Earth. EDRS-C also hosts HILAS-3, a communications payload for Aventi with flexible capacity over Africa and the Middle East. EDRS-C is the second satellite based on OHB Small GEO platform, with the first one launched in 2017 by InSpace. Let me now introduce to you the head of EDRS infrastructure at Airbus, Mr. Matthias Wiegandt. Good afternoon, Matthias.
Good afternoon, Marie-Laure.
Matthias, could you explain what is the main mission of EDRS?
EDRS is the first commercial optical network in space and based on cutting-edge laser technology. The associated ultra-broadband services are marketed under the Space Data Highway brand. It includes services for Earth observation, satellites, UAVs or mission aircraft. Our launching customer is the European Commission's Copernicus Earth Observation Program. The data relay service to the Sentinel-1 and Sentinel-2 satellites allows the delivery of large volumes of time-critical data to Earth monitoring centers within Europe in near real time. Before EDRS, a process that would typically take several hours. EDRS will be the second communication node, followed by a third satellite over the Asia-Pacific region by around 2024. Equipped with three laser terminals, EDRS-D will again significantly increase the communication capacity and its coverage.
Thank you, Matthias. Let me now introduce to you the EDRS project manager at ESA, Mr. Michael Whiting. Good afternoon, Michael.
Good afternoon, Marie-Laure.
Michael, since when has the EDRS service been available and how will EDRS-C contribute?
The commercial EDRS service has been available since November 2016 via EDRS-C's sister payload EDRS-A. EDRS-A was launched in January 2016 as a hosted payload embarked on the Eutelsat 9B satellite. Today, more than 23,000 successful links between EDRS-A and the Sentinel satellites have been executed, with more than 1 petabyte of Earth observation data transmitted to the ground. By the end of 2019, the system will also provide a fully European broadband communication service to the Columbus module of the International Space Station. From 2021, the Pléiad Neo Earth observation satellites will begin to use the Space Data Highway. Once launched, EDRS-C doubles the capacity of the system, ensures in-orbit redundancy in case of potential technical issues, and, owing to its different orbital position compared to EDRS-A, enlarges the visibility window between EDRS and customer satellites like the Sentinels.
Matthias, what are the challenges and main features of EDRS?
The heart of our system is a laser communication terminal developed and built by TESAT Spacecom, an Airbus subsidiary. While this technology was used in the past for experimental application on TerraSat-X, ENFIRE and AlphaSat, we are the first using this technology for a commercial service on standard telecom platforms. During development and implementation, we had to cope with a number of technical and operational challenges. Compared to conventional radio frequency systems, a laser terminal has a very narrow beam and therefore comes with unique requirements on pointing knowledge and stability. Specifically, if one takes into account that our system is designed to support point-to-point connection over a distance of up to 70,000 kilometers and data rates of 1.8 gigabits per second. And the concept of operation is quite different as well.
Michael, who are the key players within the EDRS program?
The EDRS program has been implemented via a public-private partnership between the European Space Agency and Airbus Defence and Space. While ESA's role has been to cover the main technical risks during the development phase of the cutting-edge optical inter-satellite laser link capability, Airbus has been covering the risks related to the market introduction of this novel service. Airbus has also been acting as the industrial prime contractor at system level. The system is jointly operated by Airbus and the German Space Operations Center. While the heart of the EDRS, the laser communication terminal, has been developed by TESAT with funding from the German Aerospace Center DLR, the EDRS-C satellite has been developed and built by OHB Systems. EDRS-C also embarks the HILAS-3 Ka-band communication payload owned by London-based telecommunication operator Avanti Communications.
Over those 4 years, Hainspace and Airbus have built strong links of cooperation and coordination in the frame of the execution of the launch services contract. On behalf of Hainspace, I would like to sincerely thank our customer for their trust.